This video is intended to help you visualize the front, top, and right side views of the objects in exercise 2.5. So the first object is 2.5 number 1, and this is the isometric view of it. This is what the front view would look like. We'll go to the top view, back to the front view, and then to the right side view, back to the front, top, front, right side, back to the isometric view. This is the second object on exercise 2.5. This is the isometric view. Here's our front view. Then we'll go to the top, back to the front, and then to our right side view, and back to the front. And I want to point something out to you, that the angle of this plane that we see right here is different than this hidden line that we see across here. So I'm going to go to the isometric view so you can see that. This plane is not coplanar, or with this line right here, which is this crease where these two oblique planes actually are coming together right here. So we have to sort of grid this out and then connect the dots to get these views. So I'm going to go back to the front view. So you can see this angle changes just a bit as it when it reaches this surface here. And then we're going to go to your top view. So this is one of those oblique planes. This is one of those oblique planes. And then this, of course, is an inclined plane. And then we'll go back to our front view and then turn to the right side view. So here's our inclined plane, and here is an oblique plane, and here's an oblique plane. And then back to front and back to our isometric view. Model number 3. We have a front view. And I want to go back to this. You will see a circle right here, but it's actually this feature back here. So this should be hidden lines. But for some reason, the modeler here is showing that as visible. And this will be a hidden line going across here. So front, top. This is one of those cases where when this arc here blends in, when it blends into this surface right here, there will not be a line showing here or here. That's called a run out. It just runs out into there. So there's top, front, right. Front, top, front. And for some reason, the model's showing a hidden line here, but actually, what that would be is a center line running down through here for this half round cutout that you have here. All right, back to the isometric view. Part number 4, front. And you can see the hidden lines created by this, the edges here and down here and on over on this side for the slot that goes through. It's running up and down vertically through there. So front, top, front, right, front, top, front, right, isometric view. I'm going to spin that one all the way around so you can see what that would look like if you could see that cutout with visible lines running through it. Problem 5, front view, top view, front, right, front, top, front, right, isometric. Problem 6. This one we have a hole going through and intersecting on an inclined plane. So that's going to give us some interesting hidden lines probably. So here's our front view, top view. So you can see where this hole intersects with that plane underneath that inclined plane, that we're going to end up with an elliptical shape. And the width of that ellipse would run from, if we projected from this intersection where the hole intersects the inclined plane here, and then where the hole intersects here, when we project that up to the top view, that defines how wide the ellipse is along this axis here. The width of the ellipse will be whatever the diameter of the hole is. So top view, front view, right view. So right side view, front view, right side view, front view, top view, isometric view. Project number 7, front view, top view, front view, top. Now, this line here and this line here are actually going to be hidden in the top view. So we have to kind of watch out. And this line here and this line here will be hidden. It's just that the model that I'm using here is not doing a very good job of showing us that those are hidden. Right view, front view, top view, isometric view. Model number 8. Now, this one, the front view is actually going to be this view here. If you look at the arrow in the exercise, it says to choose this for your front view. That would make this the top view. Let's go back to that front view. Back to the top view. So these lines that are showing as solid lines here are just tangent edges. You can see them come around. There's actually not going to be a line there that'll be a visible line, but I think you are going to have hidden lines that run through vertically in this case. Back to the front view. Here is the right side view. Back to the front view. Back to the top view. Back to front. Right, isometric. All right, so this is the 9th object. This one is a little tricky because we have a slot intersecting with this half round shape that we have here. So front view. Top view. Now we go back to the front view. So notice where the slot comes and hits this half round shape right here. So it hits inside this corner here. It's over to the right of that. Over here, it's over to the left of that. Now watch when I go to my top view. So you're going to have a hidden line coming in, a hidden line coming in. And where this line begins right here, that's going to be a visible line. You're going to have the same thing on the opposite side. And those will project from the points where this hidden line intersects the half round. They're going to project up to your top view. So top view, front, right, front, right. So you can see this hidden line here is the bottom of the half round. And then there will not be a visible line here and here. Those are just those tangent edges. So let's go back to the isometric view.